Dear friends, welcome to new class, new session. Before this, we discussed about the technical terms or terminologies commonly used to describe the flower. Today we are going to discuss about the topic arrangement of floral parts on thalamus. We know that flower comprises four different types of floral parts: calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Calyx is made up of sepals, corolla is made up of petals, androecium represented by the stamens, and gynoecium comprises the carpels. ಹೂವಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಭಾಗಗಳಿರ್ತವೆ. ಕೇಲಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರೋದು ಸೆಪಲ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ, ಕೊರೊಲ್ಲ ಆಗಿರೋದು ಪೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ, ಆಂಡ್ರೋಶಿಯಂನಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೇಮನ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತವೆ, ಮತ್ತು ಗೈನೋಶಿಯಂನಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಪಲ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಇದನ್ನು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ನಾವು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ನೌ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಲೋರಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಥಲಮಸ್. ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಥಲಮಸ್. ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಪೆಡಸಲ್. ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫ್ಲವರ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅ ಪೆಡಸಲ್. ದ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೆಡಸಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪಾಂಡೆಡ್ flat, it become expanded, and this expanded structure provide the place for the attachment and arrangement of floral parts. This part is called thalamus. Andre ee pedicel na tudi swalpa agalavagi bere bere huvina bhagagalu idara mele vyavasthitavagi arrangement aaglikke, attach aaglikke adu ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಭಾಗವನ್ನು ನಾವು ಥಲಮಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಲೋರಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಥಲಮಸ್, ಬಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ದಿ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಓವರಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಲೋರಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಥಲಮಸ್, ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈ ದಿ ಫ್ಲವರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ತ್ರೀ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್, like hypogynous, epigynous and the perigynous. Okay, so here flowers are classified into three categories, but this classification is mainly based on the arrangement of other floral parts with respect to the ovary on the thalamus. Here sepals, petals and stamens, all these three different types of floral parts, how they are arranged with respect to the ovary present in the gynoecium. Based on this concept, we classify flowers into hypogynous, epigynous and the perigynous. Andre ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಲೋರಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಥೆಲಮಸ್ ನಾವು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾಗಿ ತಿಳ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾಗಿರುವಂಥ ವಿಷಯ, ಸೆಪಲ್ಸ್, ಪೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸ್ಟೀಮನ್ಸ್ ಈ ಮೂರು ಹೂವಿನ ಭಾಗಗಳು ಗೈನೋಶಿಯಂನಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಓವರಿಯ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯ ಸಂಬಂಧವನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿದ್ದಾವೆ, ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿದ್ದಾವೆ, ಅದು ಬಹಳ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್, ಹೈಪೋಗೈನಸ್. When we observe the hypogynous, say here, this is thalamus, this lower part is pedicel, idu pedicel, this is thalamus. On thalamus, first we draw gynoecium, this is ovary, this is ovary. Now here you observe this stamens. Diagrams are very important to describe arrangement of floral parts on the thalamus. Next, petals. Sepals. Means here this is sepal, represents the calyx, petal represents the corolla, this is stamen, and here this is completely gynoecium, this part is ovary. Okay, so here this flower is said to be hypogynous. What is the reason here it is said to be hypogynous flower? You observe this one, anthalamus, ovary comprises superior position and other floral parts like stamen, petals and sepals are originate from base of the ovary and they comprises lower position or inferior position with respect to ovary. This type of flower is hypogynous. Andre ee thalamus mele nodidaga ovary elladkinta mele barutta adara kelagade inda ee ovariya kelabhagadinda stamen, corolla, calyx ulidiruvanta bhagagalu utpatti aagtave. Ovariyu melina bhagavanna melina hantavanna ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಉಳಿದಿರುವಂಥ ಭಾಗಗಳು ಅದರ ಕೆಳಗಡೆಯಿಂದ ಉತ್ಪತ್ತಿಯಾಗ್ತವೆ. ಇಂಥದ್ದು ಹೈಪೋಗೈನಸ್. ಹೈಪೋಗೈನಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಫ್ಲವರ್ ವೇರ್ ಓವರಿ ಕಂಪ್ರೈಸಸ್ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಥಲಮಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಮೇನಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ಲೋರಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟೇಮನ್ಸ್, ಕೊರೊಲ್ಲಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕೇಲಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಒರಿಜಿನೇಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಓವರಿ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಥಲಮಸ್. This is called hypogynous flower. Means in this hypogynous flower, ovary is superior and superior ovary is represented by the symbol. This is the symbol indicates the superior ovary. ಓವರಿ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಇಂಥ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್ ಓವರಿಯನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸೋ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಸಂಕೇತವನ್ನು ಬಳಸ್ತೀವಿ. ಜಿ ಬರೆದು ಅದರ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಒಂದು ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಗೆರೆಯನ್ನು ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಿ. ಈ ರೀತಿ ಬರೆದಿವೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿಂಬಾಲ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಓವರಿ ಈಸ್ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್ ಓವರಿ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಹೈಪೋಗೈನಸ್ ಫ್ಲವರ್. ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಹೈಬಿಸ್ಕಸ್, ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಚೈನಾ ರೋಸ್. ದಾಸವಾಳ ಹೂವಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಥ ಒಂದು ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ನಮಗೆ ಕಂಡು ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ hypogynous flower. Next we proceed with the epigynous flower. You please observe this one, you will get complete idea here. Okay, this is gynoecium. Here this is thalamus. This is thalamus, stamens, petals, sepals, like this here. This is epigynous flower. Epigynous flower. Now you observe this diagram. Here this is ovary. This is ovary. Now thalamus. You observe this one. Here in this diagram we observe that ovary comprises the superior position and it is on topmost position on the thalamus and remaining floral parts commonly originate from the base of the ovary. Hypogynous, ovary is superior. Here I will write. Now you observe this. Here ovary is completely embedded within the thalamus. And thalamus is grow in the form of rim or receptacle. And from the margin, from the rim of the thalamus, remaining floral parts like stamen, corolla and calyx are originate. Due to this, ovary comprises inferior position compared to remaining floral parts like stamen, corolla and the calyx. This type of floral part or this type of condition is said to be epigynous. Epigynous is the flower where ovary is inferior, ovary completely embedded within the thalamus, and remaining floral parts like stamen, corolla and calyx are originate from the rim of the thalamus, and these floral parts are superior compared to ovary position. This type of flower is called epigynous. Andre ee flower nalli ovary enagirutte ee thalamus nalli tumba olagade varegu hogirutte athava ee thalamus aa ovary anna cover maadi melakke belutade konege ee thalamus na rim inda tudi inda ulidiruvantaha huvina bhagagalu stamen corolla matte sepals belutave hagagi ovary ulidiruvanta bhagagalinda kelagade bandu bidutte ಓವರಿ ಇನ್ಫೀರಿಯರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಪಿಗೈನಸ್ ಫ್ಲವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಓವರಿ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಫೀರಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಟು ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ಫೀರಿಯರ್ ಓವರಿ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಟು ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್ ಓವರಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಟು ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ inferior ovary. Next we discuss about the perigynous flower. Observe the diagrams carefully. This is perigynous flower. You observe perigynous flower here. This ovary comprises the central position with respect to the remaining floral parts. Here ovary is said to be half superior or half inferior, or we can use the words like semi-superior or semi-inferior, but very popularly called semi-superior means here the ovary and remaining floral parts are almost all comprises the same position on the thalamus. Here this ovary is located on the central position of the thalamus, and the remaining floral parts are originated from the rim of the thalamus, which also comprises the equal position with respect to the ovary on the thalamus. This is called perigynous. Andre perigynous flower nalli ovary matte ulidiruvantaha huvina bhagagalu samana hantadalliruttave. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇದನ್ನು ಪೆರಿಗೈನಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಓವರಿಯನ್ನು ಸೆಮಿ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಓವರಿ ಈಸ್ ರೆಫರ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಸೆಮಿ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್. ಟು ರೆಫರ್ ಸೆಮಿ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಸಿಂಬಾಲ್ ದಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸಿಂಬಾಲ್ ಟು ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದಿ ಸೆಮಿ ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೈಪೋಗೈನಸ್, ಎಪಿಗೈನಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಪೆರಿಗೈನಸ್. Hypogynous is the flower phenomena or the condition is called hypogyny. Example reported in the China rose. Flower is called epigynous, condition is called epigyny. Example reported in the cucumber. Perigynous is the flower, condition is called epigyny. Example reported in the guava. Like this here, this is about the different types of flowers, particularly hypogynous, epigynous and the perigynous with respect to the arrangement of floral parts on the thalamus, mainly with respect to the ovary. So this is about the different types of flowers. You please remember this. Here we proceed with the next concept, calyx. We know that calyx is outermost whorl of the flower. Calyx anadu huvinalli atyanta horagade iruvantaha bhaga. Calyx is made up of units. Units of calyx are said to be the sepals. Calyx nalliruvanta units galanna sepals anta helutheve. And here when we observe the calyx, calyx is commonly classified into two types based on the arrangement of sepals. The one first group is said to be polysepals. Polysepals. Second type is said to be gamosepals. Gamosepals. Calyx classified into two types, polysepals, gamosepals. For your kind information, both the types are not present in single flower. Different types of flowers may possess any one type of calyx. So what is polysepals and what is gamosepals? Already we know that calyx is made up of units called sepals. You just observe this. Here I will draw the diagram of calyx. Imagine here calyx is present and this calyx comprises the five sepals. Here sepals, this one is, each one is sepal, and here we observe the five sepals. All these five sepals togetherly become calyx of that flower. Illi naavu sepal galanna nodta idivi. Udaharanege ee huvinalli 5 sepal galidave. Ee 5 sepal galu seri aa huvina calyx aagtave. Observe another diagram. Here also we observe 5 sepals. Here also we observe the 5 sepals. Okay. This is also calyx. Here it is made up of sepals. This is calyx. Here it is made up of sepals. This is also calyx. But what is the difference between these two types of calyx? In the first category, we observe that in this calyx, units means sepals are free. They are not fused in condition. Whereas in the second diagram, we are observing that in this calyx, all the sepals are fused to form a cup-like structure. This is the main difference. Polysepals. Polysepals is the calyx where all the sepals present in that calyx are free. Whereas gamosepals is the calyx where the sepals present in that calyx are fused with each other to form cup-like structure. So this is gamosepals. This is said to be the polysepals. This is polysepals and this is gamosepals. This is gamosepals. You remember this one. Here sepals are free and sepals are fused. Ee ondu calyx nalli sepals ella free agidave. Illi matra ondukkondu fuse aagi cup tara ondu rachaneyanna utpatti madidave. Free iddaga polysepals, fuse aadaga gamosepals. You please remember this one. Similarly we have corolla. So when we observe the corolla, we know that corolla is the second whorl of the flower. Calyx is the outermost and first whorl of the flower. Corolla is present next to calyx. Calyx and corolla both are non-essential whorls of the flower because they do not participate, they are not helpful for the sexual reproduction. And already we know that they are helpful to provide the protection to the reproductive part of the flower. They are helpful to provide some shape, size, structure, bright colors to the flowers, which is helpful for the pollination also. So here when we observe the corolla, corolla is made up of units called petals. Here corolla is made up of petals, unit of corolla called petals. And here corolla is also classified into two types, as polypetalous corolla, polypetalous, and second is said to be gamopetalous. Gamopetalous. Okay, when we observe the first one, polypetalous corolla, here these are the petals. You just observe this condition. Here corolla, it is made up of 5 petals, and all the petals are free from each other. In a corolla, when all the petals are free from each other, this condition is called polypetalous condition. This type of corolla is polypetalous corolla. ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ಕೊರೊಲ್ಲಾನಲ್ಲಿರುವಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪೆಟಲ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಫ್ರೀ ಆಗಿದ್ದು ಅಂದರೆ ಅದು ಪಾಲಿಪೆಟಾಲಸ್ ಕರೊಲ್ಲ. ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಿ ಗ್ಯಾಮೋಪೆಟಾಲಸ್ ಕರೊಲ್ಲ, ಇನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೋಪೆಟಾಲಸ್ ಕರೊಲ್ಲ ಆಲ್ ದ ಪೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್. Okay, so here you observe this. Here also we observe the 5 petals, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. But here all the petals are fused to form a funnel shaped structure, bell shaped structure, cup shaped structure. This type of corolla is called gamopetalous. It is the corolla where all the petals are in fused condition. This is called gamopetalous corolla. In a corolla, if all the petals are free from each other, polypetalous. In a corolla, if all the petals are fused to form a cup or bell-shaped structure, it is said to be the gamopetalous corolla. So like this here, this is about the different types in corolla. Here we have another one concept, perianth. You try to understand what is perianth, it is very important. See here, calyx is present, corolla is present. In a common typical flower, calyx is green color and corolla is having different types of colorations. According to depend upon the nature of the flower, the color of the petals varies. Here we can very clearly observe the corolla and calyx. We can easily differentiate the sepals and petals because calyx is very well developed, corolla is also very well developed. Both are having different types of structures, both are having major differences. Because of this reason, it is possible to differentiate or distinguish the calyx and corolla. But in nature, there are some of the plants where it is become difficult to differentiate sepals and petals or calyx and corolla. The flower in which calyx and corolla are not differentiated, then what are these structures? These structures are referred as perianth. Means perianth is the structure where it is not possible to differentiate calyx and corolla, or we can say it is not possible to differentiate sepals and petals. This is said to be the perianth. Perianth is the structure which do not shows the differentiation of sepals and petals or calyx and corolla. Then it is said to be the perianth. Unit of perianth, tepal. Just please consider here, unit of calyx is sepal, unit of corolla is petal, unit of calyx is sepal, unit of corolla is petal. Similarly, unit of perianth is tepal. What is perianth? When calyx and corolla are not differentiated, that structure is called perianth. Unit of perianth is called tepal. Supposed to be here tepals are in fused condition and free condition, then here tepals, that means perianth. In a perianth, 5 tepals are present and all these tepals are free from each other. They are not in fused condition. Then it is called polyphyllous. If tepals are fused, tepals are fused to form cup-like structure, it is said to be gamophilous. Gamophilous. You should not use the word polytepalus, gamotepalus. It is wrong. Here you have to use the word, technical terms like polyphyllous, gamophilous. Polyphyllous is the type of perianth where tepals are free. Gamophilous is the type of perianth where tepals are fused. Supposed to be calyx is present, polysepalus, gamosepalus. Corolla, polypetalus, gamopetalus. Perianth, polyphyllous and gamophilous. Like this here, these are the different types of floral parts and technical terms we use to refer the some of the descriptions with respect to the floral parts. So please remember these concepts. Further, we discuss with the new concepts. Thank you. Thank you, friends.